Leeds International School, Primary 4, Second Midterm, ICT, Unit 2, Computer Memory. Computer Memory. A computer uses memory for storing data and instructions. So my kids, in a computer memory, we can store data and instructions. However, we tend to forget things over time, but a computer can store data for as long as we want. So my kids, as human, we forget things. When time goes on, we forget things. But a computer, it can store data as long as we want. As we want, we can store data. This data can be retrieved from the computer's memory as and when required. So the data what we have stored, we can retrieve. That means we can get it back from computer's memory as we want and when it is required. In this chapter, we will learn more about the computer memory. So in this chapter, we will learn more about computer memory. Let us first get started with the units that are used to measure the computer memory. So first we are going to learn about the units that are used to measure computer memory. Measuring memory. There are different units of measurement such as grams and kilograms for weighting, meters and kilometers for distance. So we have different types of different units of measurements. Grams, kilograms, kilometers and meter. Similarly, there are unit for measuring. There is a unit for measuring the computer memory. So likewise, we have for measuring the computer memory, we can find some units. A computer can understand only binary language. A computer can understand only binary language. This is because a computer is an electronic machine and can understand only two states. So the computer is an electronic machine. So it can understand only two states, on represented by 1 and off represented by 0. So on is represented by 1 and off is represented by 0. Binary language consists of zeros and ones. So in binary language, we can find zeros and ones. These binary digits, zeros and ones, are called bits. So these binary digits with zeros and ones, we called it bits. The data is stored in the computer memory in the form of bits or binary digits. So in a computer, data is stored in computer memory in the form of bits or binary digits, that means zeros and ones. The computer memory can be measured in terms of bits. So a computer memory can be measured in terms of bits. So higher number of bits that a memory can store, higher number of bits, there is a higher number of bits, higher is its capacity to store data. So higher number of bits we can store, higher capacity of data. The capacity of a computer memory can also be expressed in terms of bytes. A combination of 8 bits makes up 1 byte. So combination of 8 bits, it makes up 1 byte. Bigger units of measuring memory. So these are the bigger units of measuring memory. Types of computer memory. The computer memory can be classified into two types. So computer memory can be classified into two types. Number one, primary memory. Number two, secondary memory. So in this diagram, you can see computer memory classification. Primary memory and secondary memory. And then primary memory is classified into two. RAM and ROM. Primary memory, it is classified into two, RAM and ROM. And then secondary memory, it is also classified children. Can you see the diagram? So this secondary memory, it is classified into six types: hard disk, CD, DVD, Blu-ray disc, pen drive, memory card. So this is the classification of computer memory. In this slide kit, you can see primary memory images and secondary memory images. Primary memory. The primary memory is also known as the main memory or the internal memory. So for primary memory, we can give two names, main memory or internal memory. A computer cannot run without primary memory. So without a primary memory, without a main memory, without an internal memory, we can't run a computer. It is that area of memory that hold only those data and instruction on which computer is currently working. So this primary memory, it holds data and instruction which computer is currently working. So the those are the data and instruction that primary memory hold. The data on primary memory is directly available to the CPU. So you can find it directly to the CPU. The CPU reads the instructions stored in the primary memory continuously and executes them as and when required. So what happens? The CPU, it reads the instructions stored in the primary memory continuously and it executes, it starts when we want it. The primary memory can be divided into two parts. So primary memory can be divided into two parts: RAM, random access memory; ROM, read-only memory. Following are the characteristics of RAM. So here we can find characteristics of RAM. RAM is read or write memory. So we call RAM read or write memory. Information can be written and read. RAM holds instructions and data on which you are currently working. So RAM, it holds the data and instruction on which you are working currently. For example, when a computer starts, when you start a computer, it loads the operating system into RAM. So for example, when you start the computer, it loads the operating system into RAM. Or when you are working on any program, you are actually working on the program loaded in the RAM. So when you load any, not only starting the computer, when you work on a computer, when you work on any program, actually you work, it is loaded in the RAM. RAM is a volatile memory. So volatile memory means, let's see what is the meaning of volatile memory. It retains stored information as long as the power is on. When the power supply is switched off, the stored information in the RAM is lost. So we call this RAM as volatile memory. Volatile memory means we can see or we can get the information as the power is on. When you switch off the computer, the data stored in the RAM, it gets lost. The amount of RAM installed in a computer affects the number and size of program that a system can run at the same time. So the amount of RAM installed in a computer, it affects the number and size of the program that the system can run at the same time. So when you look at this example, a computer having higher RAM will be able to load multiple software applications quickly. So if a computer is having a higher RAM, so it can load multiple software applications very quickly. ROM, read-only memory. Following are the characteristics of ROM. ROM is read-only memory. On ROM, data is prepared which can only be read. So here in ROM, the data we can only read, we can't do any other changes. ROM is non-volatile memory as it retains the content even when the power is switched off. So it's non-volatile. You can get the information even when the power is switched off. In most computers, ROM is used for storing special softwares. So in most computers, we use ROM for storing special softwares. Basic input output system. This software helps to load operating system when the computer is switched on. In this slide, we are going to learn about secondary memory classification. First, let's learn what is this secondary memory. The secondary memory is also called auxiliary memory, external memory, or backup memory. So for this secondary memory, we call it as auxiliary memory, external memory, or backup memory. We just learned that the computer's primary memory has a limited storage capacity and stores data temporarily. So we learned in the previous slides, we learned computer's primary memory, it has limited storage capacity and also it stores data temporarily. In order to store data permanently, you need to use secondary memory or storage devices. So if you want to store data permanently, what you have to do, you have to use secondary memory or storage devices. Secondary storage devices can store large amount of data permanently on devices inside the computer or outside the computer. So these storage devices, you can store large amount of data permanently inside the computer or outside the computer. Let us now discuss some of the secondary storage devices. Now let's learn about some of secondary storage devices. So number one, hard disk. A hard disk is the main secondary storage device found inside a computer. So this hard disk, it is the main storage device. You can find this hard disk inside the computer. It is present inside the CPU box. So you can find this hard disk inside the CPU box. It can store large amount of data. Hard disk, it can store large amount of data. All the work done on a computer can be stored on a hard disk. So all the work that you do by using the computer, you can store it on the hard disk. So when you store a program, it automatically saves in the hard disk. Number two, CD. CDs, compact disk, are circular in shape and can store lots of data. So you have seen a CD, so it's circular in shape and also you can store lots of data. They can be easily carried from one place to another. So this is a portable storage device. You can carry from one place to another. Most of the programs and games that you use on your computer are available on CD. So most of the time, the programs and the games that you use on your computer, you use are available on CDs. CDs can be two types. CDR, it is called recordable CD. Data once recorded on it cannot be removed. Okay, so cannot be erased. We call this a CD recordable. Then CDRW, it is called rewritable. Data written on CDRW can be erased and new data can be stored. So in this CDRW, you can, if you have written some data on it, if you want to reuse it, what you have to do, you have to erase the data and then you can reuse it back. Third storage device, a DVD, digital versatile disk, looks like a CD. So this digital versatile disk, it looks like a CD. A DVD is capable of storing 6 times more than a CD. So the capacity is more when you compare with a CD. Also, a DVD can be single or double-sided. A DVD can be used to store many movies. So a DVD can be single or double-sided, and also we can use this DVD to store many movies. Blu-ray disc. The name Blu-ray disc is derived from blue-violet laser. It is used to read and write this type of disc. So we use this blue violet laser to read and write on this type of disk. A Blu-ray disk can be store more data than a DVD. So when you compare this DVD and Blu-ray disk, you can save more data when you compare with the DVD. One Blu-ray disk can store 25 GB of data, which is over 5 times storage capacity of a DVD. So this DVD, it has a larger storage capacity 5 times when you compare with the DVD. It is mainly used for storing high quality video files and video games that require large amount of storage space. So we use this Blu-ray disk to store high quality video files and also video games that you play. It requires a large amount of space. So in that case, we use this Blu-ray disk. Pen flash drive. A pen drive is a storage device which is very small in size. So this pen drive, it's very small in size. So even in this slide, you can see a picture of a pen drive. It can be easily carried in a pocket or a keychain. So you can carry it. And also it is a portable device. You can carry it from one place to another. A pen drive can be used to store and transfer data from one computer to another. So by using a pen drive, you can transfer, you can send data from one computer to another. It can be connected to the USB port of a computer. So in the CPU, you can find USB port. So if you want to port the pen drive, you can use this USB port. Memory card. A memory card is small in size and is used to store data in various electronic devices like mobile phone, digital cameras, MP3 players. So this memory card, it can be used in various electronic devices. We can use for the mobile phone, digital camera and MP3 players. And this memory card, those are portable devices. Portable devices mean we can carry this device from one place to another. Thank you, and God bless you, my kids.